If you reside in Lagos, Nigeria, then it's no longer news that the Lagos State Government has banned the use of Okada and tricycles, popularly known as keke, on major roads. Following the ban, which took effect on the 1st of February 2020, Nollywood actress and producer Uche Jumbo says, "Why do we have inconsiderate leaders?" So she's asking a series of questions, but I think that's the major part of her tweets. Why do we have inconsiderate leaders? Do you think our leaders are inconsiderate?
I would say they have been inconsiderate according to this ban, because if you're going to do something as radical as this, as banning Okadas, keke napeps, which are tricycles and motorcycles, right? I think there should be an alternative in place for people to... Now, we started seeing funny things, and people think it's actually funny, but it's not funny. It's just what we've been reduced to: people getting on horses to get to their destination, people getting on bicycles to get to.
Is that really true?
No, it's true. Oh, wow. I saw one today. I don't know if, but at least I saw, no, not even one. I saw two. I saw a girl dressed nicely on her horse. Do you understand? And I saw another guy in suits on a horse. Wow. But I don't know if that's within the Oniru access, mm-hmm. because obviously they're accessible to stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if that's just the reason why that is happening around here. I don't know if that is how it's going to be everywhere in Lagos.
I saw a blog just before it went live now, and it was a series of horses. Let me not say plenty horses. Like, people were on leads and they're saying that's now. But I don't know what the Lagos State Government hopes to achieve with this. They want a mega city, a sane city, but things don't just happen.
I have a feeling this is for a purpose.
People have been asking the people in government is what is supposed to be the alternative, and they keep saying we are working on the alternatives, and that is where I have a problem. I'm not saying don't ban Okada. If that's what you think is best, fine, but what did you expect? What was the alternative to fill this gap that is apparently open in the transportation system? In fact, having keke and Okada was not even filling the gap completely. Now it's like a lacoon, and you're saying they are coming, we are launching 65 buses. Do you know how many Okadas you took off the road for you to replace them with 65, and you say,
and even those buses are not going to go to certain areas.
Certain areas that Okadas can get to. Mm-hmm. I think for me, I'll first of all say that kudos to Uche Jumbo, because she's the only celebrity that
we've spoken out publicly.
Yeah, I mean, I was thinking about it yesterday, and I'm saying, so because it doesn't concern
them. It's almost like because it doesn't concern them, there's nothing. And again, I would say that what she said and what the government has done is just a hint at the fact that the people who are in power don't really care about the average Nigerian. Because when you are setting rules or you're setting laws or whatever it is that you're doing, it should be for the people. Mm. It should not be because we want Lagos to be a mega city. It should be, okay, we are creating a plan that can serve the people. Let's listen to what the people want. There was none of that.
I don't think it's a case of them not thinking of the average people. I think it boils down to incompetence. Because now, some of the arguments that the troubles the Okada and the keke people have caused, when you go to people places like Igbobi and hospitals, the statistics are there. Like, it is massive. Like, people have lost their limbs, their legs, and all that due to the recklessness of these drivers, right? We understand that you want to keep us safe, you want to keep us alive. But the level of negotiation and conversation that went into this, I think it happened within a group of incompetent people. Because if you're competent, then you need to have done the legwork. Don't just sit in your office. Do the legwork. Understand the areas that have these issues. Because there are areas that you've taken keke and bike away, and there's absolutely no means of transportation. You need to walk. And how many people can walk? You know, so you can't force a certain lifestyle on people. And some people are saying, oh, it's now good, Lagosians will exercise. Sorry, it is not your place to tell us how to exercise or when to exercise. I know exercises are good, but I don't want to exercise when I'm all made up and going to work. If I want to take a walk, I know when to wake up and take a long walk, not when I'm going to work.
But I think people should also get educated on these bans, because there are certain areas that the cicadas have been banned, but
yeah.
because of the law enforcement agencies we have, like, they don't even regard that. Mm-hmm. Even in an area where it's not affected by yeah. this ban, you still see people seizing or impounding yes. okadas and kekes yeah. because they're trying to make money. Even though they know that, okay, you have the legitimate right to be on this
mm-hmm. road. I even saw a video of them trying to impound a delivery bike, which is absolutely wrong because the delivery bikes are not affected by this. And I saw a tweet from the special, I think they call them SSA, I don't know if they're advisors or whatever. Or to the governor on media, he was saying that they should reach out to them if anybody tries to impound the delivery bike because it is not part of the...
I think we're just saying behind the scene that, you know, imagine if this happens and then you can't get your deliveries to you. Yeah. Like, what are you going to do? So everybody will have to drive down to yeah. these places where you order online to go yeah. and pick up your yeah. stuff.
You also mentioned something very important, the law enforcement people. We know how irrational they can be and how they take things out of control. I mean, even a street that is not part of this band, they just go into it because they feel like if they pick one or two yeah. bikes, they'll be able to get some money from it. You know, yeah. the corruption is deep in that side of the economy. Mm-hmm. And I just hope that they can really come back to the table, because I think conversations yeah. need to go back into what they have done. We also see protests from what do they call them now? Gokada Max NG yeah. and all yeah. that. They organize
Gokada people. Actually affected, you know, by this, because I feel like those people are even more regulated. They have
I see
safety,
them wait for, you know, they have all the traffic lights. I see thing. Like they don't just they've been following
the rules.
I see
them ensuring you have your helmet.
And at some point they said
they follow all the safety rules.
They said the law was 2000. What's the bike specification called? Something 2000 DS or something. And theirs is about 2200. So why can't they be allowed once they are regulated and can assure you that they won't go beyond a certain rule?
You know, initially I thought it was a business strategy for this online bike what's it called now? Services.
Biking services.
Yeah. So I was thinking, okay, it was a strategy to get more people on those applications so that you request your bikes and then they make more money. And I was thinking, okay, it's one of those things that the government, the corruption, do you understand the corruption in the country? But when I now realized they banned them, I was like, so what exactly is going on? Because we've seen a lot of people complaining. People, they call them rants, but they're not rants. It's just your pain. It's who is wearing the shoe that
will
know where
it's by. She was making 20,000 naira daily from driving. I think she was on the Gokada platform and she used that to see herself through
school.
ND in school and now she's on IT and she's supposed to go back for her HND and she doesn't,
she,
you know, it's a sorry case.
It's
and
already,
I just hope conversation
it's already
resumes.
Bad enough that the people that ride these okadas and keke napeps are uneducated and desperate to make money.
Not all of them are uneducated.
No, okay, okay, let me be fair and say not all of them, but majority are uneducated and desperate people. Now I it's not right to generalize that, but I'm saying this because what would actually push a person to be riding okada or keke napep is unemployment, especially
survival.
For those that are educated and survival. Do you understand? So by the time you take their source of livelihood, some of them live in the ghetto where they've avoided peer pressure, they've avoided crime by having a daily source of income. Now, do you want these people to now fall back to those? Because
according to the Lagos state government, they said they want them to learn more skills, bricklaying, plumbing, all those kind of skills. That's the reason why. They said they realized that most of our youths, instead of taking to learning those kind of skills, they are now like doing okada and keke napep.
And then
so
they should get on the bus conductors
to
them.
But I just feel like, while I feel like the Lagos state government might have good intentions, whatever it is that they have done, they did not do it proper. Yes, they did not think it through. And what
it
they have done,
being incompetent.
What they have done is to just leave a lot of Nigerians at the mercy of.
Going to stop. I just hope that they come back to the table and discuss and them understand what they are doing, because I feel like they don't understand the gravity of what it is causing.